Hello everyone, in this video, we will learn how to compute the size of periodic payment for ordinary simple annuities using a financial calculator. The financial calculator we're using is Texas Instruments BA2+. So in this problem, periodic payment is asked for, right? PMT is asked for. The payments are made at the end of each month. This end indicates it's an ordinary annuity as opposed to annuity due. And the number of payments in each year is 12 because there are monthly payments. The interest is compounded monthly, right? So P value is 12, C value is 12, and therefore because these two numbers match, it is a simple annuity. So 8 years is the loan term, so T is 8. And the amount of loan received was $32,000. So our PV is $32,000. Because it is a cash received, it is considered cash inflow and it's entered as a positive number. 3.8% is a nominal interest rate. It's an annual interest rate. So this is our I per year. So before we enter in the values, we need to clear the TVM worksheet. So we press second. And we press FV. So now first, let's enter the number of payments per year and the number of interest compounding periods per year. We need to go to PYCY worksheet by pressing second, and then we press I. Now, PY is set to 1, and if I use this down arrow key, to go to CY, CY is set to 1 as well, right? So I have to change these two to 12. For simple annuities, this PY and CY are equal. And then every time you change PY, then CY is saved to the same number automatically. So for example, in this case, if I change number of payments to 12, and then I press enter, 12 is stored to PY, and then I go and double check the number of compounding periods. And it's, as you see, CY has changed to 12 as well. So for simple annuity, all you need to do is to change PY, and CY changes to the same number automatically. Now, in order to exit this PY-CY worksheet, you can press second and CPT to activate the quit button. Now, let's enter the total number of payments in the term, which is the number of payments in 1 year, which is PY, 12, multiplied by the number of years in the term, in this case, 8. So 12 times 8, it's 96. 96. And then we press the corresponding key for N. And as you can see, N is set to 96. Now we press clear. For interest rate, all we need to do is to enter 3.8, and then we press I, clear, and then move on to the next value, which is our amount of loan. Amount of loan is received first, and it is repaid in the future through the payments, and therefore loans are usually considered as a present value. So we enter 32,000. As I said, 32,000 is cash inflow, and therefore it is entered as a positive number. We press PV. We clear, and it is time to compute the size of payment. In order to do that, we press CPT. And then we press PMT key. So as you see here, PMT is calculated as a negative number or as cash outflow, which is the case when a loan is repaid, the payments are considered cash outflow. So if you are to round off this number to the nearest cents, the answer will be $387.09.